I think it'd probably be surprising to most people that jeans are one of the absolute worst items that you can buy, and they have a very negative impact on the environment.
It takes a lot of water to make denim. And so if we can repurpose and reuse this kind of fabric and these classic pieces of American style, it's good for the environment.
We believe in the recycling of clothes. So there's an environmental impact, which is good for everybody and keeps away from landfill. Customers get very good clothing at a very good price.
$1.7 million Australians buy at least one pair of jeans every month. But in a world of fast fashion, our denim obsession has some serious environmental and social impacts, starting with the crop it's made from, cotton.
It's very water intensive, in fact the most water intensive and pesticide intensive using plant that has grown.
Dr. Rebecca Van Amber has been researching the environmental and social impact of denim for years. She says the fashion for sandblasting, distressing and fading our jeans has huge consequences.
Dyeing is definitely one of the worst aspects. It produces a lot of effluent, and the effluent is really toxic because of the dye and the salt used in the dyeing process. A lot of the dyeing is done in places like China, and the dyeing effluent or wastewater from the dyeing process is simply put straight into the streams, so it contaminates the local people's drinking water.
Australians buy 27 kilograms of new clothes each year, which is more than double the global average. We then throw out 23 kilos of clothes each year, 85% of which ends up in landfill, where it takes hundreds of years to break down. But there are some people working to mitigate the effects of all that discarded denim.
Every year we process around 12 million kilos of clothing to go either into our retail stores or our export business. I'm Rick Mulhall, I'm General Manager of Recycling for the Smith Family. This is our centralised recycling facility where we bring all the donated clothing the Smith family gets and we sort it into its various sales channels for resale. There's over 50 people working in this facility. We see a substantial amount of denim come through. The best figure I can give you for denim would be that around 30,000 kilos per annum we resell in our stores and export.
In a world of fast fashion, for me, I'm just trying to create something that's unique and special for people.
From recycling to upcycling, Kai turns plain old denim jackets into sought-after fashion accessories.
My name's Kai Brown. I'm a designer and a chain stitch embroidery artist. Chain stitch embroidery was something that was invented in France over 100 years ago. I've got a crank underneath the machine where I'm like turning it, and this axis is on a 360 axis like a pencil. So essentially you're drawing with thread. A lot of the original chain stitch stuff was car clubs, hot rod scene in Southern California. The interesting part about chain stitch embroidery is it took over in style and fashion in the US, probably around about the 40s through like the 70s, even the 80s. It's something that's very much a bespoke style now. I love vintage denim because it has a life and it has a story to tell. Da was my grandmother and probably one of the most influential people in my life. She would repurpose things and recreate things. And I had this old denim jacket and she like laid this piece of fabric out and she sewed it on, and it was incredible for me. I started wearing the jacket and people were just constantly coming up to me and asking me like, where did I get that jacket? Would I sell the jacket? You know, what I was wearing was special, you know, and people connected to it. When my grandmother passed away, I felt this like great need to continue on something that she was passionate about.
While Kai and the Smith family rescued discarded denim, some Aussie scientists are creating a spray-on denim look with almost no environmental downside.
So we take the jeans and we start by cutting them into snippets, and from that we grind them into an even smaller size. So we end up with a particle that's sort of like very, very minuscule. And from there, we take that particle and we mix it with what's called a binder. It's essentially a glue. We spray it onto the surface of the fabric, the white fabric. We then dry the fabric, and then the fabric is ready to be used. The starting material is waste, so that should be free or almost no cost. And our process doesn't involve any heat, we don't involve any chemicals, so it's a very green process.
The beauty of Rebecca's method of colouring the denim is that she can use poorly made, fast fashion items.
With this technology, there will be some new kind of fashion effects that might come out of it. You might not need to sandblast the jeans. You might be able to get that same effect using the spray application of the particle. We really want this to be picked up by the industry.
While Rebecca is looking to overhaul the entire industry, Kai's happy having a smaller, more personal impact.
I like to say what we do is thread-based storytelling, because we're able to give people a piece of a memory, and that's really powerful. I think if my da was here today, she would be really proud.